So while Peter is setting up this quiz,
I will explain the... Yes, please come back. I will explain the rules. Peter and I cannot win this quiz, so don't worry. You make
an... Actually, we would win this quiz.
Yeah, but we won't, yeah. Right? Yeah. People that are present in this room, those are the only ones eligible for the prizes. So if you're participating remotely, you're more than welcome to try and compete, but you cannot win the prize. There's another disadvantage for remote people. The system we use, it will... Bologna.
Reward.
Excellent. It will reward you not only for the correct answer, but there is a sort of amplification factor that is time. So the faster you answer correctly, the more points you will get. So if Peter answers within a second, he might get, say, 900 points. And if I take my merry time and answer 15 seconds later, I will still get some points, but just not as much as the first guy to answer correctly. If you answer incorrectly, you will get no points. How many of you were here last year and have experience with the system? Nice. So you're ahead of the game. What other rules are important?
Not sure. No cheating.
Oh, internet connectivity.
Yeah. Whip out your smartphones. You'll need them. Or your laptop or iPad or whatever has a browser.
Maybe disable your Wi-Fi. Because if all these people...
Disable 3G and Wi-Fi.
It might be of interest to the people in the back that actually want to win the prizes to come a little bit to the front so you can more easily read it, or indeed cluster under these displays. Bert mentioned that there might be tax rules applicable if you win the prizes. To me, the main prize is a worthless set of integers, so whatever way you want to declare it at your tax agency, that is up to you, not our problem. And if there are any liability problems, they are Eric's problem. There are 25 questions. And may the odds ever be in your favor. Let's go.
Kahoot.it.
The instructions will be on the screen.
This is not the game pin. This is.
Okay, maybe turn that off. Oh, it doesn't work.
No, it's HDMI audio.
Oops. Isn't there a button to turn this off?
I don't know. Is it heel erg?
I hope the music is license free, royalty free.
Hoeveel mensen moeten we hebben?
Hij is iets...
Ja, ik weet het. Ik denk dat het in orde is.
Ja?
Ik hoop het.
Nou, we kunnen ook de browser iets kleiner maken.
Beter, hè?
Ja, misschien het dock even wegpoetsen.
Turn hiding on. Ja, you should do it. Vraag maar of iedereen er is.
Did everybody join?
Ja. Wel audio uitzetten trouwens.
Doe maar.
Thank you.
Ja, doe maar eens terug.
Ja. Oké.
Okay. 70 players. Are there even that many people in this room?
Everybody's got two hands.
Yeah, true. Did everybody join?
72.
Ga ik even.
What is the ultimate tiebreaker in Cisco's best path selection algorithm? Lowest neighbor address.
Oh, this is bad.
Ooh. Wait, Peter. Did everybody understand that the colors and shapes correspond to the thingies on your cell phone, right? I'm just checking.
Everybody ready?
Yeah.
This is top five.
Nice.
The rest of you suck.
What is the attribute value of the well-known BGP community, no exports? Remember, the slower you answer, the less points you get. I'm not trying to make you nervous. But you better push that button fast.
Some people are taking a long time.
Internet?
Nice. Well done. Indeed, this is a bit tricky, but this is the official assigned attribute value in the IANA registry. This is no advertise, and this is no export BGP Confederation, but written in a different format.
These two are actually pretty close together, right?
Yeah, like they all differ by one.
Yeah.
It's, yeah.
Okay. Jeeves is on top. Huh? What does DFZ stand for? There's a hint. I think the hint is working.
Is it on mute?
Default free zone.
What? How did... Who did this?
This is contradictory.
Wow. All
right, next. He's still on top. This is an IP tables firewalling question. The rules are coming
up. Go, analyze it!
I think they're guessing.
Nope. The reason why...
guessing.
You want to explain it? You have the mic.
The rule, as you saw it, it was 0000/00001. And that is actually a wild card. And this prevents, this basically classifies all IP addresses that are an even address. And 8888 turns out to be an even address when converted to an integer. This is basic stuff, people.
You're a horrible man.
Wow, somebody.
Which of these addresses is valid?
Well, it's just better than I anticipated. This one has too many double colons, and this one has too few integers. And this is actually an IP address that falls within the IPv6 discard prefix that IATF specified in RFC 6666.
How many delegations are in the root zone today? They're all with too many options. Five more seconds.
Now this is real guesswork. Excellent.
Yes, you will love the next question. How many of those are signed with DNSSEC? I initially had a fourth part up to 2000, but
over 9,000.
Realize that all those new fancy GTLDs like .economy and .whatever are mandatory DNSSEC signs. So this explains why the number is maybe higher than you would intuitively expect it to be.
Another example of people doing DNSSEC for the wrong reasons, of course.
Yep.
For money. Okay, next question.
Which of these open resolver surfaces validates DNSSEC?
There was a very small accidental hint in my presentation, but...
Oh, who will remember?
Two valid answers here. This is the open DNSSEC validating resolver. But not many people know of it.
And the other one is Google DNS. They actually do the right thing here.
Yeah. Open DNS does the other right thing. All right. Marcus is really picking up.
How many times...
How many times has the root key signing key been rolled since July 15th, 2010?
Not a day earlier.
Yeah,
Oh.
I found this question in the DNS quiz and did not have the date, and it turned out to be a trick question because there were some experimental roles before that date. But this is the date that DNSSEC went into production at the root, and there have been no KSK roles since, which is very sad.
Anything scheduled?
Yeah. People are fighting about it. Okay. Well, the next question is similar. How many times has the root zone signing key been rolled since that same date?
Works.
Oh, no, it works.
The ZSK rolling ceremony can be viewed online when it happens.
It happens roughly twice or three times a year?
It's happened, I think, 22 times now in 5 years. So, like, four times a year. Okay, next question. Marcus still in the lead. Who is Marcus?
Marcus, raise your hand.
Well done. Well done. Keep it up. Okay, last DNSSEC question, I think. What is the weakest crypto used in, that's a weird sentence, in the full validation path of any common DNSSEC deployment?
Who is the weakest link?
You're just describing the picture.
I can do that.
The ZSK we mentioned earlier, the one that does get rolled frequently, is currently 1024-bit RSA. This is actually one of the topics on the discussion for rolling the KSK, whether they should change the algorithms. Okay. Let's move on. A non-DNS question. Yop.
What is the Amphero ports range as defined by RFC 6335?
The picture is a hint if you don't know the word. I'm sorry if that didn't help.
Obviously. These are also These are also called the user ports, I believe.
No, that's the blue one.
There we go. But these are the ports applications can use when they initiate a connection to a service and they're unprivileged themselves. So this is all the dynamic crap.
Well done, Liter. Okay, what is the IANA assigned port number for service IRC over TCP?
What was it again? Why is the display wobbly?
What?
194!
So if you accidentally picked green while you meant yellow, it doesn't matter.
I imagine this came to be in a time where people didn't want to run their IRC daemons as root user, and they started at a higher range, which was unprivileged, but I don't know.
Yeah, the yellow one, I think it's called RCU in the IANA port listing. But I admit, I have never seen an IRC server on 194. I'm getting close to 10,000 points. Okay, Job.
What is IP protocol 112 according to the IANA assigned internet protocol numbers registry? What is protocol 112?
Wee wee. We should have made a follow-up question. What is the number according to OpenBSD?
Oh. So what happens, VRP was defined in the ITF, but it, there are some people that argue that it was encumbered by patents. And then there were some folks at OpenBSD who were like, oh, I'm going to peel over that and use the same protocol number. But IANA dedicated it to VRP, which is incompatible with CARP. HSRP and GLBP are entirely different gateway redundancy protocols. What is the one possible state in the TCP state machine directly after close wait? Now, all of you have memorized that image where the state machine of TCP is described.
I don't even know what it means.
Transmission control protocol.
What's this? I knew that.
Last egg.
Now explain why.
The other side indicates I want to close. This one acknowledges. Then the other side will move into closing. And then after that, you have closed.
I believe you.
But there are, I think, 22 states or something. And it's a bit of a complicated diagram.
This is about nicknames on IRC. I'm guessing his name is Mike.
Maybe. Yeah. Or maybe not. Michael from Smallenburg.
Well,
so join our IRC channel. It's on IRCnet in #NLNOG.
Hashtag NLNOG these days.
Whatever.
Marcus and Liter leading together. Okay.
What does an autonomous system number cost at RIPE NCC for an LAR?
Did you just go, oh fuck?
That's right. An AS number does not cost a single thing.
I see RIPE employees going shit. We have breached 10,000, or at least two guys have. Okay, question 18. What is the latest stable version of the Mutt mail client?
Of course. Nice.
The four is even.
The last stable release was released 5 years ago.
No. Six? Or six?
Maybe six, yeah. Even.
It's terrible.
The last version was released a few weeks ago, which was, I celebrated.
Yeah, that's the 1.5.24, right?
Yep.
Yeah. Okay, couple more questions. You tried it? I know some of these words. Yep.
How many VLAN tagged Ethernet frames can you transmit per second over a 10G interface? And this is important
well done.
Knowledge. All of you were guessing. So, I've had so many times customers complain that somewhere around between 10 million and 14 million packets per second, they couldn't fit more through the port. I'd be like, well, it's the theoretical limit. And they're like, I don't care, I want 20 million packets. So this one is VLAN tagged, this one is untagged, so that packet is smaller, so you can fit more per second through the interface. This one is double VLAN tagged, and this one is MPLS tagged.
And you can already know this when you make the question.
Capacity planning.
How many IPv6 prefixes are being announced in the DFZ today?
Yeah.
There's overlap in the answers.
I think you'll manage.
Currently, roughly 25,000 prefixes are in the IPv6 default free zone, depending on your viewpoint, peering, or transit arrangements.
Not a TCP question. What protocol offers the highest amplification factor? Do you know what SSDP is?
Something discovery protocol.
Thank you for that.
People really, really want to know what time it is, and to achieve maximum accuracy, they will spend gigabits on retrieving that information. A good second one is, I believe, DNS.
No, in factor, charging still wins because you send one byte and you get like 300
That's
back
right.
on average.
Charging is at like 300 times.
Yeah, and DNS involves a 60, 70 byte question and then at best 4 kilobytes in return.
NTP's amplification factor is upwards of 500 times.
Yeah.
Because you send one packet, and you get many back. Packets
right.
for everyone.
What version of the Rhipe Whois server is running on whois.rhipe.net?
If you would subscribe to the database working group mailing list, you would know this immediately.
Job added the fourth answer initially. It just said Java.
That's probably the right answer. Yeah, it's always the
answer. 1.80.1.
This looks like guessing to me.
Yep.
Okay, whole top 5 above 10k now. This is to be expected. Couple more questions. 3 more. What does L2ARC stand for in ZFS? Shall we do 10 seconds next year?
Yeah, why not? Not guesswork, but wrong guessing.
Looks like guesswork to me.
Well, at least people realize that 2 of the options are not viable.
Right. Okay, 2 more questions.
Which country, according to Snowden, was accidentally knocked offline in November 2012 by the NSA?
Looks like people know this, or they realize they should be really quick with the guessing.
Guessing,
yeah. It was Syria.
What the NSA did, they tried to compromise a border router, apparently the only really important one in Syria. And they kind of botched it up, and there was an oh oops moment. And they bricked the device, so then Syria was offline for a couple of hours while those engineers were like, what? Hello, Cisco, can you help us?
I wonder what Cisco told them.
Your service contract is no longer valid.
Okay, this is the scoreboard before the final question. That is more than 1,000 points difference.
So people are essentially competing for the second prize, I guess.
That's also almost 1,000 pounds. Well.
We shall see.
Do your best. What brand virus scanner / firewall disconnected you when you received start keylogger? This is some time ago. You don't want the PI space? Do you know what it's worth?
Yes.
Okay. Do you know what it will be worth in 2 years when you can finally sell it?
Norton. They had this ridiculous parsing engine that if it received that key, it would just kill whatever it was doing.
Also stop keylogger. Okay, well, let's look at the final scores. Marcus, get up here.
Marcus! Woo! Congratulations!
You win nothing!
What are you going to do with it?
I think the wrong answer is not really a clue, as I'm officially not even a network engineer, but a hosting operations engineer. Yeah. So I actually manage our web hosting platforms, our DNS platforms, and I think that's where most of the knowledge and a bit of guesswork came from. So we'll see.
Right. I guess it's time for a career switch.
maybe.
Eric, please come on stage and we'll have an official moment here.
So, gefeliciteerd bij deze. We gaan komende week even wat heen en weer mailen, want ik heb wat gegevens van jou nodig.
Yes.
Je krijgt van Prefix Broker aangeboden een /24 PR space. Die krijg je op naam. Volgens RAI Policy betekent dat je hem 2 jaar op naam moet hebben, minimaal. Daarna ben je vrij om te doen ermee wat je wil. Tot die tijd.
Hey. Alsjeblieft. Ja, alsjeblieft. En je hebt een foto. Moet je hem houden.
All inclusive. Gefeliciteerd.
Ja, dank
je. Liter.
For some reason.
I need to stress that although Peter is my coworker, he did not see the questions.
Niels.
I think Job is looking for the prize now. It's some serial USB Bluetooth thing for network engineers. Now we need networking hardware, yes. This is a very expensive gift for us.
Microfoon.
Ik wil geen reclame maken, maar dit is echt een geweldig apparaat, hè? Job die had al verteld van Bluetooth en wifi en console. Wat hij nog vergeten was, dat was dat je ook, er zit ook een TFTP-server in. En je kan dus ook bridgen tussen je wifi, de gewone ethernet, Bluetooth, alles heen en weer op en neer, serieel. En, nou, helemaal geweldig. Okay. Dus dit gaat helemaal lukken. Heel veel plezier ermee.
Dankjewel. Third prize. What was the third prize again?
Let me check with our price suppliers. Roderick, waar ben je?
That's a big stack. All right.
Misha, please come forward.
This is going on my CV. After winning this, I can get another job, a different kind of job. Oh, and I'm so happy I didn't win the first prize. That would be a horrible conflict of interest.
Well done, well done.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
This prize is offered to you by Triple IT, our streaming partners, the camera people, the live stream. That's all them. And
I don't know who will be happier with this, my son or my boyfriend.
Why not both? All right, Martin, get up here.
Martin Pels.
Also well done.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I'm proud of you. You did well. You fought.
Will the real Arthur please stand up?
Arthur, congratulations.
Thank you, Will.
So, you need to rate this quiz before I can move on to see the whole scoreboard. So, please do that now.
Can we now click final results?
I'll wait for a few responses. I'm not sure.
Oh, okay.
out of 5. Turns out later on I can download an Excel sheet and it will say 4.6, 0.9 or whatever, or 1 in this case, I guess. But it makes no sense if you haven't seen this screen. All right, let's go on. Save results. Do you have Excel on this thing?
Yep.
Okay. What did you expect? Excel for Windows? So let's see. Marcus Liter. Yes. Next one is Freek. Johan.
Freek.
So as you can see, we know exactly who made what mistake.
Gefeliciteerd.
Who will be passing this on to your employers. All right. Two more. XYZZI. Sounds like a Rush song. Sizzy? Where?
Maybe that's a remote participant?
I'll have that one then.
Nobody is claiming this one? Next.
Months? Months CZ? Oh, you can see it here. Mans CZ. Yeah. There we go. Woo!
Van harte gefeliciteerd.
Dank je wel.
Alsjeblieft. And the last one is TV. Ah, Teun.
Teun, gefeliciteerd.
Do we have any more prizes?
We're out of prizes now.
Okay.
But we have a prize for everyone. Pizza, spare ribs, beer, wine, sodas.
Yay! When?
I am amazed how precisely on schedule we work today. It is 5:30, and we're not a minute late even. Thank you all for attending.
Thank you for participating.
Oh,
yes,
oh, interruptions.
Natalie still has to... Isn't that the second time you did that today?
Yeah, maybe.
I do realize I'm standing between you and beer. So, don't worry. I'm going to keep it very, very short. There are just some people that without this day, it would just wouldn't be the same. And I just want to spend a moment on behalf of the NL NOC board to thank them in a proper way. So, first of all, that would be our dear catering company, Tante Tay. They took well care of us. They left now, but they took well care of us, and I really appreciate it. Then, I would like to see Anna up here. Anna Woo! From the Red Dress Effect. Without Anna, we wouldn't look this pretty today. She made the banners, she designed the t-shirts, and so she made us look good today, and I want to thank her very much for that. But there you go. Then, of course, the excellent content. We saw a whole bunch of excellent presentations today. And first, I would like to thank one of my fellow NL NOC board members. Let me see. Sorry, I need some goods here. Yep. Niels? Yeah? If you have a second, please. I would like to thank you very much. So, Niels, there you go. Yeah. We're going to do this quick, but are you still here? Yeah, oh, here you are. There you go.
Thank you.
Ooh, this one's still in plastic. Peter, thank you. Very quick. Christian, still here. Christian 1 and Christian 2. Two Christians. Alsjeblieft. Oh, alsjeblieft. And one for Christian. Christian, right. There you go.
Thank you very much.
Alsjeblieft. Yep. Bert, are you still here? Yeah, yeah. Excellent presentation. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
We saw two presentations, three I think today from you. Job? There you go. And last but not least, from our own treasure. Oh, nu ga ik ineens in het Engels. Onze eigen penningmeester, Thomas. Dankjewel. Oké. Dus dat waren de mensen. Dan zijn er nog een aantal bedrijven waar ik echt wel gewoon een heel hard applaus voor wil. Ten eerste is dat natuurlijk Prefix Broker. Voor die enorme goede prijs. Superleuk gedaan. Er zitten hier beneden de hele dag al jongens in een vrachtwagen. En daarachter zitten de jongens op de camera's. En die hebben de hele dag gezorgd voor, ik weet niet hoeveel mensen we op de stream hebben gehad. Maar ik heb tweets voorbij zien komen van mensen die de stream goed hebben kunnen ontvangen. De hele dag door. Dus jongens van Triple IT, ook ontzettend bedankt voor jullie hulp. En last but not least, Dat is onze sponsor voor de venue. En niet alleen de sponsor voor onze venue. Ze hebben ook de pizza's gesponsord. Ze hebben ook het bier gesponsord. Niet aflaten op Leaseweb. En dat brengt ons bij het feit dat we kunnen afsluiten. We kunnen lekker naar beneden. Alles staat al klaar. Over een half uurtje wordt het eten bezorgd ongeveer. Maar de taps gaat zo open. En, sorry? De taps gaat nu open. Yeah. En ontzettend bedankt. We hopen dat jullie ervan hebben genoten. Tot volgend jaar. We hebben nog geen datum.
Volgende event in Utrecht, de NL Nog Borrel in januari.